Hello students, this is Divyansh Sharma. I hope you all are safe and doing good. This session is for class 10th students. Today, I will be starting chapter number 1 of science subject, that is chemical reactions and equations. Before getting into the details of the chapter and the concepts, firstly I would like to discuss why we are studying this chapter. So the name of the chapter is chemical reactions and equations. Therefore, majorly the chapter is divided into two important parts. The first part is dealing with the reactions, and the second part is dealing with understanding the equations behind those reactions, and hence it completes the total chapter chemical reactions and equations. You might have seen a lot of chemical reactions in your daily life. The reactions do not just take place in your chemistry laboratory. They also take place in your daily life, such as the turning of milk into curd when left at room temperature, the rusting of iron, the cooking of food, also the digestion of food into our body, and there are a lot of examples to quote. But if the reactions are taking place in nature only, the question arises, why we are studying these chemical reactions? So my dear students, reactions are of two types. The first type is desirable and the second type is undesirable. You know, the turning of milk into curd is a desirable reaction and the rusting of iron is an undesirable reaction. Hence, we conclude that at some point we want the reactions to happen and on the other point we don't want the reactions to happen. That is why we are studying the reactions so that we can control the reactions. This is an important point. So in order to control the reactions, we are studying them in detail. And in this chapter only, you will getting into the details of controlling the reactions, details of functioning of reactions and how they behave when some reactants turn into products. Let us take the first example, which is given in your NCERT also, that is the burning of magnesium ribbon. So the burning of magnesium ribbon is a very famous example. There are some important points related to the burning of magnesium ribbon. Firstly, we have to rub the magnesium ribbon. We rub it with the help of a sandpaper. Now the question is, why this rubbing is required? I'm giving you this question as a homework. After rubbing the magnesium ribbon, we will hold the magnesium ribbon with a pair of tongs and then bring it towards a spirit lamp or burner. Once the magnesium ribbon start burning in the presence of air, we will be able to see dazzling flame and the ribbon will change into white powder. This white powder is magnesium oxide. Now from class 9th, you know how to write magnesium oxide chemically. So the chemical symbol for magnesium element is Mg. For oxygen, it is O. Magnesium has a valency of plus 2. Oxygen has a valency of minus 2. When we will cross multiply the valencies of the elements, we will get the final product as MgO. So this is the chemical formula of magnesium oxide. Let me show you a small video of burning of magnesium ribbon so that you can understand it more clearly. So students, I hope you have noticed the results of the video. From the results, we can conclude that whenever there is a chemical reaction takes place, there are certain things which can be noted from the chemical reaction. The first thing is change in state. The second thing is change in color. Third thing is change in temperature. Fourth thing is evolution of a gas. So these are the four important things which you can notice through a chemical reaction. And if we want to write the chemical equation for the reaction which you have just seen through the video, the reaction would be Mg, that is magnesium, plus O2, that is oxygen, gives out MgO, that is magnesium oxide. So this is the chemical equation of the chemical reaction which you have seen. Now there are two major parts of the chemical reaction or the equation. The first part is the reactants that are used in a chemical reaction. The second part is the products. Product can be single or it can be multiple products depending upon the type of reaction. Now the another part of this chemical equation is balancing. That is, we need to balance the left hand side and the right hand side of the reaction or the equation. So in order to balance, I want you to first revise the law of conservation of mass which you have studied in your class 9th. I'm giving you this as a homework to revise the law of conservation of mass which you have studied in your class 9th. I expect that you will study it, and hence you will be able to find the amount of reactants used in the reaction and the amount of product formed after the reaction in terms of number of moles, so that in next lecture we can start with balancing of chemical equations, and hence we can perform 3 to 4 examples in order to validate balancing and to learn it properly. This is all about today's session. So you have 2 questions for your homework. The first question is, why we rub magnesium ribbon before burning? And the second question is, what is law of conservation of mass and what is the amount of reactants that we have used and the amount of product formed in the chemical equation Mg plus O2, which is giving out MgO. I hope you have understood the concepts which we have discussed in today's session. In next session, we would be discussing the balancing of chemical equations and the properties of a chemical reaction. Thank you for watching this session. Please complete your homework before watching the next video session for the chapter.